Welcome back, everyone, to Art with Haley, or Art with Miss Yale if you are at Hogg Elementary. Last time we were starting our self-portraits inspired by Frida Kahlo, and I have been working on mine. I know, it looks just like me. Well, I'm going to show you a couple of videos to show you how I ended up making mine look like me and follow the guidelines. You can see that my eyes are halfway down, my nose is halfway there, my mouth is halfway there, my ears fit here, and I've added tons of details to make it look like me. And then we're going to work on our backgrounds today, also inspired by Frida Kahlo. So, welcome back! So, that just looks like a regular person. It could be anyone. So now I'm going to go ahead and add the details to make it look like myself. What details do you have that are different than everyone else? Okay, one thing I forgot to teach you last week is about our necks. So a lot of people make their neck too skinny. And so I want to show you that your neck actually comes down from where your ear is. So you can have your ear here, and you're going to want to follow down your chin. And when you get to your mouth, that's where it curves in. Follow it down from your ear till you get to your mouth, and then add the curved line. And then from there, you can make whatever shirt you want, and make sure that your shoulders go farther out than your head. If you're looking at me, my shoulders are way out here. So make sure you don't do them too close. Well, I hope that you enjoyed that. So now we're gonna work on our backgrounds, and I'm gonna give you two choices. You can be inspired by one painting of Frida Kahlo's that she has a forest behind her, lots of plants and nature, and she even has an animal on her shoulder and some butterflies. Like, she has taken herself out of being in that boring old bed, so sad, so boring, and she put herself in one of her favorite places out in nature. Let me show you that painting really quick in case that's what you want to do. So here you can see the painting. She has tons of leaves behind her, bright colors. I see some dragonflies, I see monkeys, I think maybe that's a bobcat, I'm not sure. And she even put a necklace around her neck that looks like it's made of nature. I think she chose this so that she would see herself in a place that makes her very happy. Where do you see yourself that makes you very happy? Okay, so if you want to do that one, you're in a perfect position to start because you have your self-portrait already ready. Already ready. And you would just fill the whole background overlapping. Remember, overlapping is when one thing is in front of something else, so it covers it. Well, you will be covering part of your background, so it's good that you drew yourself first. And then you could add plants, or maybe you want to be at the beach. You could add the water in the background. You could add umbrellas, beach ball, whatever you want. So now make your background. Your second option, which is the one I'm going to do, is inspired by Frida Kahlo's painting called The Frame. And she puts a frame around her head of all the things that make her feel happy and the colors that she likes. So let me remind you of that painting now too. Okay, here is the painting called The Frame. Look at all the bright colors. What kinds of things do you see? I see flowers. I see two birds looking at each other. I see some designs that I'm not sure what they are, but they are bright colors, so maybe these are her favorite colors. And it looks like she put everything around herself like she's the star of the show. And behind her, it's just one color. All of the drawing goes around the edge. Okay, so as you can see, Frida loves nature, and so do I actually. So that is why I love her artwork so much and would have probably liked her. So if you're going to do the frame, I want you to fill all the edges of your picture with things from nature that make you feel so happy. And I want to remind you that food also comes from nature, most of it. So if you wanted to include bright colored things like fruits and vegetables also, you could do something like that. So we could use flowers, we could use plants, we could use sticks and branches, we can use any animal you might find in nature, butterflies, birds, worms, if you like worms, boys. And then also I'm gonna include some of my favorite foods, like maybe a mango or strawberries, and then just fill it all around your whole face. And then, of course, you can color it. Well, there it is. I didn't finish coloring it yet, but only because I don't want to take too much of your time. But you get the picture. I just surrounded it with my favorite flowers and plants and animals and fruits, and I began coloring. I did add this part here. That's kind of like Frida's painting the frame. As my background color. This really helps make the face stand out instead of just all being white. So I hope that you have a great time making the frame around your self-portrait and that it is a colorful, joyful picture and piece of art for you today. I miss all of you a ton, and I hope that you're having a great time at home. I have another video idea already, so stay tuned.